Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be all about stocking stuffers. Now I've kind of already done what I got my kids for Christmas and a little bit of what was going to be in their stockings, but not totally. This is going to be adding to that, and it's also going to be what I got my husband in his stocking as well. So I have a 3-year-old little girl and a 9-month-old baby girl, and of course my husband. So that's kind of our little family, and I'm just going to show you some ideas of what Santa may leave. Some things that he likes to leave normally in stockings. So maybe he'll bring similar items this year. So that video is going to start in just a second, but I wanted to quickly just put a disclaimer on once again, everybody's budget's different. Everybody likes to do big stockings, little stockings, no stockings, whatever. And this may just be crazy much, I'm sure it is, but I think that's good for you because it gives you a lot more ideas of things to go ahead and do. And I know that Christmas is almost a week away, so I feel like stockings are kind of like more of the last minute things that you kind of check off your list, and sometimes you just like are stressed and want to get it done and you can't think of ideas. So I'm hoping that I give you ideas all across the board with different genders, different ages, different relationships, I don't know. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and if you are interested, then just keep on watching. Alright, so I was going to do this on like a cool flat lay format, but then I realized that I think it would look way too overwhelming. So we're just going to hold up each gift like usual. Anyway, so the stockings that I use are from Target. They're these kind of sweater knit, cable knit stockings. We have E for Eleanor, O for Olive. My husband's named Jazz, so he just has a red one with the letter J. They bring these back every single year. I mean, for the past, at least 5 years. At least 5 years. So they've had them for a long time. And I was worried they weren't going to bring them back this year, and I was able to get Eleanor's this year. So they are not super stretchy or super giant, so some of these stocking stuffers won't fit in here, so they're not necessarily stocking stuffers and will have to just be on the side. But you know what, that's just how life is. I like to stuff stockings and go crazy. So I guess we'll just start with Eleanor. I do want to say that a couple of these items are from what I got my kids for Christmas video, just because those were meant to be stocking stuffers, and I think I kind of said that, but I didn't do a full video, and I kind of wanted to do a full video, especially because I have extra things and I wanted to include my husband's. So first things are food and treats. Now my youngest is 9 months, so she can't obviously have like candy or like gingerbread cookies or something like that, but she does love to eat and she does love to snack. So we have two different types of yogurt melts. We have the Gerber Graduates fruit and veggie melts, very berry blend, and then we have mixed berry parents choice. Don't remember buying either of these, just found them, so they're unopened, they're going in the stocking. I also bought the little crunchies from Gerber. These are the ranch. She actually doesn't like these, and I didn't realize that until after I bought these. So at least she has two things of yogurt melts, and she doesn't like these. I think her sister does anyway. So they'll get eaten somehow, somewhere, by somebody. The next three things are actually things that I did show in my video of what I got my kids for Christmas. So I'm just going to quickly breeze through them. But I think these are great options, especially if you're looking for a young baby. And you don't really know what to put in their stocking. A little sippy cup and a snack cup. Eleanor's getting to that age where she's gonna start using a sippy cup, and we're gonna start weaning off the bottle when she's one. And then snack cups are great because those melts, puffs, anything can go in here, and she can just stick her little hand in here. This keeps her entertained, happy, fed with snacks. And then this is just kind of a fun sippy cup. She's super attached to her bottle, so I think it's going to be really hard to get her solidly on a sippy cup, but we will see. But I think those are great options. And other things are pacifiers, if your kids like pacifiers, like a new Wubba Nub or something like that. Those are always nice. And I talked about this before, but this is the baby banana, and I don't think I said what this was, but this is actually an infant toothbrush. Now, Eleanor doesn't really have any teeth yet. She's way behind on the teething. situation, but my first one was too. But this is still good for teething, or just kind of rubbing against the gums. It's great for teething, it's great for having them brush their teeth, and it works really well. I really like it. Like I said, they have it in different colors, they have it in different types of food, and they're inexpensive. I got this at Walmart, but I know they have it like Babies R Us and stuff like that too, so just check it out. And the gift that you guys haven't seen for Eleanor is this. This is her book. I told you guys in my What I Got My Kids or Kids for Ms. Videos video. Okay, wow, that was stuttered. I told you in that video that I like to get my kids books. Or at least I like to get Ollie books. This is Eleanor's first Christmas, so this is kind of her first time getting books. Now, we have tons of baby board books, so I didn't get a new one of those. One, because she's not super interested in actual just books yet. I don't think they hold her attention quite yet. But this one is still a book. It'll teach her to know that the story comes, and every time you flip the page. But it's interactive, so it'll read you the storybook. It'll read you each line on the book, and it lights up. And it's easy to open and close. It's kind of fun. It gets her into being interested in books. This was only like $5 at Walmart, so I will probably just take it off and it'll fit in it once I actually just take it off and shove it in. So I think all those will actually fit in her stocking. I may have to shove and it may be like overflowing, but they'll at least fit in there. So okay. Next is my three-year-old. Some of these things, like I said, I've showed you before, but I wanted just to include them for maybe if you haven't seen my other video, and also just to give you some ideas of stocking stuffers. Bath products, great for kids, stocking stuffers. It's easy, especially if they need something like bubble bath. You can just put it in the stocking stuffer, and this type of year, they always come out with fun things. This is the Peppa Pig body wash I got from Target. It looks like a really pretty perfume bottle. This is cotton candy scent. I know she's gonna love this. These are bath bombs. You can get bath bombs all over now. They used to be kind of hard to get, and now they're everywhere. There's like Hatchimal bath bombs, the LOL doll bath bombs, bath bombs. I got this little cracker of three different bath bombs. These are Minnie Mouse from Target as well. These are both in the stocking stuffer section. Like I also said, I get underwear. I always got underwear when I was a kid for Christmas. And now I'm gonna start the tradition with my girls. So this is Olive's first year, well, first Christmas where she's been potty trained. She's been potty trained for a good while now, but not since last Christmas. So she has her first Christmas underwear pack. We have just three little pairs of Hello Kitty. My husband also gets underwear every year. I've done that since we started dating, which I know is kind of weird, but I just always tell me what I've done. But his underwear hasn't come in the mail yet, so I can't show you his undies, but I don't know if you want to know them, but they're actually really cute. Anyway, next thing, fun things for their hair are a great idea. I showed you these before too. These are the hair scrunchy tie pom-poms, and they just come in all these different colors, but they are so fun, and pom-poms are really cool and hip right now, but I think just fun like barrettes and stuff for their hair are great, and they're easy just to kind of shove in. And take up space if you don't know what to put in them. As you guys know, Ollie is getting a big dollhouse for Christmas. That is something that she's asked Santa for, and something that Santa said that he was bringing. So we have multiple just little Barbie clothes and accessories. As you can tell, these are super clearanced at Target. So I've had these actually for a really long time. And I just think that these are great. These are super easy. They add to the theme. I kind of like to add to the theme of whatever their like big present is that they're getting, especially whatever Santa likes to leave. So these are some of hers. Anyway, if you haven't seen my video, let me just quickly go. These are just three different dresses. They're virtually pretty much the same thing, just a different pattern. And then this one is just an accessories set that has like little baking tools and stuff like that. So. Okay. Whew. Ollie's treats come in the form of candy canes. These are Paw Patrol candy canes. She's obsessed with Paw Patrol. But I didn't get her any Paw Patrol actual toys this year because she already has a bunch of Paw Patrol toys that she asked specifically for other things, so I didn't worry about that. But I know how much she loves Paw Patrol, so she will have some fun curly Q candy canes that I got at Dollar Tree. Dollar Tree is great for cheap candy. also at Dollar Tree, I got these, which are the Ring Pops, but I also have seen these at Walmart. Did I get these at Walmart? Maybe I got these at Walmart or Dollar Tree, but either way, they're a dollar or under. And these are just 4 different Ring Pops. Gonna take them out of the bag, pop them in there. And the last little treat she's getting, I found this at Target in the stocking stuffer section. These are kind of like a Kinder Egg. They're the Milk Chocolate Candy and Toy Surprise. They're Finders Keepers, that's the brand. But this is Peppa Pig. She has a bunch of Peppa Pig figurines, but I think she'd actually really love this because it's fun. It's kind of like a Kinder Egg, and they have all the little Peppa Pig figures you could get. So we will see what we get. All right, coming up on the end for Olive. Now, this kind of goes in her beauty section, but this is also something I talked about. She's obsessed with lipstick, makeup. She watches me do it and she wants to do it herself. So I just got her very own little baby lips, tinted, colorful chapstick. Fidget spinner, this is something she's been wanting for so long. I guess she must have saw a video where fidget spinners were a thing. I have had this for so long. I think I've had this since July or June, and I'm surprised I didn't lose track of it. But this is just a fidget spinner that is from the Target dollar section. This was $3, wish was a dollar. I don't know why it was $3. It's pretty heavy, so maybe it's pretty heavy duty, but this is something she's been wanting for a long time. I hope she's still as excited as she was in July when she gets that. And the last two things are kind of a random thing. I'm really working on Olive holding a pen or a pencil correctly and working on her writing and being able to kind of draw and write her name and things like that. So, and I also ordered something that was supposed to also go in her stocking too, is just a preschool little workbook that she can start working on with me at home. She knows all of her letters and her numbers and her colors and all that stuff, but I really want her to work on writing. That's where I feel like she's kind of behind a little bit on, so we're gonna work on that. So what better way than to get fun pens? So these are from 2 different places. This little one I found yesterday, and this is a pom-pom one from Target, and it's just super cute, and a big little pom-pom. Big little, just a pink fun pom-pom. She loves pink anything, and this was $1 exactly. I'm gonna have to get that back in there. Shouldn't have taken it off, because now it won't be back in. Oh, there we go. And it's just a cute unicorn up there, so that'll win, so $1. And then this is like a crazy one. This one I just randomly stumbled upon in Walmart. I don't remember even how I found this, but I think it was like in his little loner self, and I found it on a shelf, and I was like, well, you're coming home with me. And this one just has a bunch of pom-poms. She's super into pom-poms too, I don't really know why. And it's pink and fun, and so, and this one has a pin cap. I don't know if either of these actually work. We're gonna find out, but I think it'll be fun and a good way to get her enticed into wanting to learn to hold a pen correctly and practice her circles and lines and writing her name and stuff. So, there we go. Oh! Last but not least, this was hiding. I finally managed to get my hand on an LOL doll. Every freaking place I've gone has been sold out. It doesn't matter what time of day I go, what day of the week I go, whenever they get new shipments or not, I can never get my hand on one of these. I found it one day hiding behind, I think it was like in the bath fizzy ones that they have, the small little ones, and it was hiding in there. And I was like, thank the Lord, I finally got my hand on one of these. It made me want them more for her because I was like, I can't get one. So I finally got it. I was really excited. I wanted to get the big one, but whatever, whatever. She got this one. That's all she needs. I don't care. It's done. Okay, now we are moving on to my husband. So, my husband has some random things, but I actually think they're really useful. I don't think there's anything that's in, like, super specific to him. I think all of these would be really good for any kind of man in your life. So, first things for him are his only treats are a giant thing of Three Musketeers. These are just the fun size. I think there's 12 in here. Yeah, 12. I hate Three Musketeers. Ugh, I think they're disgusting, but he really likes them. So that's his one treat, and it's perfect for the stocking because either you can take them all out or you can just stick it in. This is like long and thin, so you can just stick it in and kind of hold up everything in the back. Next, I went axe curling. crazy and I don't really like Axe, but it's kind of how it happened. So I always get him body wash every year. I get necessities. I think those are always nice because it's things that you don't want to spend the money on, but you need to spend the money on because you actually need to have shower gel and stuff. Or soap, at least to wash your body. So I ended up getting him this one. This is actually the one that Ollie picked out for scent-wise. I don't know if he's gonna love it. It's Axe Island, it's the white label. It's really coconutty. But I think it smells really nice. I just don't know if he's gonna like it, but whatever, he's body washed, so he'll use it. And this is something that he really loves, and I think this is a great stocking stuffer too. This is just an Axe two-sided shower tool. So there's like the kind of like a very abrasive scrubby side, makes me think of like a soap sponge or like a dish sponge or something. It's pretty abrasive. And the other side is a loofah, but this side kind of soaks up the product as well, so it works both well on both sides, and I think you're supposed to actually put the soap on this side and it drains through. I don't know, something somehow it works, but he needed a new one of these, so I got him one of those. And next, this was at Walmart. I don't know if you can get these in other places. I'm sure you probably could, but this one is the Axe head to toe style gift pack. So it comes with two flexible paste, like kind of pomades. This is the exact hair product that he uses for his hair. He really likes it. We've gone through so many different hair products because either they get discontinued or we can't find them anymore, or they get overpriced or whatever. We just stop liking them, whatever. When I say we, this is he. I mean, it's not like I'm like, oh, let's see how we like this together. Let's do your hair together. I don't know. So he found these and he's been really liking these, and I like the way they smell. So, and the fun thing about this one is it comes with a pair of socks. So I thought that was kind of cool. So this is his little hair stuff. So I can either take both of these out and kind of shove them in there so they'll fit, or I probably will end up wrapping this one. All right, speaking of socks, I got him some fun socks. So he works in a environment, I don't know where I was going with that, where he wears suits and ties to work every day, and he loves to wear fun socks. I think that's like the cool thing to do with suits or something, I don't know. Tell me if your husband or boyfriend or if you or whoever likes to do that too. So I like to buy him socks. I normally always buy them for every Christmas and every occasion as well because he wears them all the time and they just, obviously you need new ones. So the first set are from Kohl's, and they're from this brand called Funky Socks, and these ones have these cute little doggies on them, and they have little sweaters, little Argyle sweaters. And then this came with the two packs, so this one just has basic Argyle socks on the other ones. These are a bit more toned down, they're not as crazy, not as vibrant, and they'll go with more of his things, but they're still really cute. These were originally $10, but I think it was buy one get one half off, and I got another pair of socks for somebody else because socks, you know. So I got these for like $4. And then these little guys were from Target in their dollar section, and they were only $3. So this was a total win. I think they're so cute. They're like these little buffalo check shirts. I think I gave him one or two already pairs of the Christmas socks for men this year, and they're so cute, and I'm really excited to give them these because they're not overtly Christmas. I feel like they're still wintry. And then, is this it? Oh, almost it. This is the second to last thing. This is awesome. This is a magnetic air vent car mount. Now, he already had one of these, and something happened to it, it broke or something, so I got him a different brand, and this one actually came with the two packs, so God forbid one breaks again, he has another one, I don't know. But these have like really high ratings on Amazon. They're super inexpensive, and they're really easy. It literally just it magnetizes on your car, so you just have a mount, and you can just, you know, put on music or talk or map or whatever without hands-free, being safer. So this is from Max Boost. I mean, it's just kind of generic, I don't know, but cool, exciting, he wanted this, so, and it's like perfect stocking stuffer. Last but not least, I got him a mug. Now this one says Hubby. I actually call him Hub, so I kind of wish it said Hubs or Hub, and then I would just like Sharpie an S on the end. He doesn't drink coffee, but he's starting to get into coffee, and I'm obsessed with coffee. It means a lot to me. I know that sounds so stupid, but I've worked as a barista for a long time in my life. I just have a really close relationship with coffee, and it makes me excited that he's finally liking coffee, because it was something I've always wanted to share with him. It just sounds so stupid, I know, but he's finally getting into coffee. So I have the wifey mug, and I decided to get him the matching hubby mug, and I think I'm gonna get little hooks so we can hang them side by side on our counter, because we're silly and stupid and cheesy. But I'm really excited to give this to him, because it's more of a gift for myself of like, you can have, I will make you coffee if you would just drink it with me. Alright, so that is the end of this video. I hope I gave you guys some ideas for some stocking stuffers, and from all different ranges, ages, and genders. And yeah, so thank you so much for watching. Have a Merry, Merry Christmas, and I will see you guys all very soon. Bye, guys.